Ms. Wadhwa holds an and is currently working as Senior General Manager, Design and Development of Smart Grids We're talking about smart grids in India. So let's welcome Ms.
Topic for today's panel discussion is smart solutions in energy management. So when we talk about smart, what is smart? Is it only healthy, fit, or somebody who is able to sense and take action? Somebody who is able to sense and then take action means one who is adaptive will be smart. So if we apply the same analogy to our energy management solutions, something which can sense what is happening in the energy systems and then adaptively take some action. So that will be smart technology. And in fact, it's very interesting to know that we have progressed from technology to solutions. So it's not just technology that is going to make the difference. It is the complete holistic solution, end-to-end solution, which will make the difference. So, and that solution is not just limited to technology, but will also involve the associated changes in the business process, maybe people skills and policy level. So smart solutions will comprise of technology, people, process and policy. When we talk about the smart grid journey for India or smart solutions journey for India, if I progress from smart grids to smart solutions, so it started long back in around 2012 when India Smart Grid Task Force and India Smart Grid Forum were constituted by Ministry of Power to figure out how this advanced technologies in the form of ICT amalgamation with power sector can play a role in the upliftment of the sector. And our transmission grid was already having advanced technology or smart technologies deployed, and that is how we were able to manage one grid, one nation, and the grid stability was also managed with the help of advanced SCADA and maybe the other solutions. Now we have progressed from smart SCADA systems to VAMS in the transmission sector, and there were absolutely no challenge. We are one of the pioneers globally in transmission system management. The sector where we were lagging was distribution sector. So the thrust was on the smart grids journey for distribution sector, how smart grids can make a difference in the distribution sector. So when those two institutions were crafted, their role was to figure out what are the advanced technologies available, what are the ICT solutions deployed globally, and how we can adapt those systems for our Indian systems. And lot of changes were happening at that time in Indian power system as well. There was a target for having 175 gigawatt of renewable energy by 2022, and of which major part was from rooftop solar technology. The adoption of electric vehicles is also increasing. Then we have smart sensors which are there, and also ICT solutions. So these are some of the disruptive changes that are changing the present sector of power in India. With these disruptive changes in the power sector, there are certain challenges for distribution companies. Now they need to manage a mobile load in the form of electric vehicles, and they cannot really figure out what time what person is going to, at what time and what place the electric vehicles will be put to charge. They are also to figure out the challenges associated with harmonics that will increase because of increase in the ICT solutions deployment as well as electric vehicle charging facility requirements. At the same time, they are to manage their financial positions as well. So how do they really manage these challenges? Also, the losses, the aggregate technical and commercial losses are increasing like anything. So whether these smart sensors or smart solutions can really help the distribution companies to manage their financials as well. With that thought, it was found some pilots were crafted. So the 11 pilots were sanctioned with 50% of funding from Ministry of Power. And in those pilots, one of the major components was smart meter. Why do we need smart meter? Because we need to sense what is happening at the last node of the power sector value chain. If we are able to measure what exactly is happening at that last node, then and analyze what actions are required and act accordingly, then it will be definitely helping in improving the sector's health. And in fact, the success story of pilots was really appreciated even at global level, and we realized many benefits, some of which was reduction in the AT&C losses. How do we achieve this reduction in AT&C losses? One of the outcome was that the commercial efficiency increased, the collection efficiency increased. How that increased? Because the smart meters had that connection and disconnection feature also in that meter. So the DISCOMs were in a better position to collect the dues from their non-paying consumers. So that way we also realized better revenues. So that was a financial gain for the distribution companies, and also optimal asset utilization was one of the benefits. How do we go for optimal asset utilizations? We started measuring what was the percentage utilization of the transformers, and we found that most of the time, maybe 20% of the time only, the transformers are utilized for 80% of its capacity. So most of the assets in the pilot area were underutilized. So can we replace these transformers by adequate capacity transformers so that we can reduce the technical losses? And also we can reduce the technical losses if we are able to manage the phase balancing. So these were some of the solutions which were taken up at the pilot level. And the success story was really very encouraging. And that is why the Government of India has now decided to launch this revamped distribution scheme, of which the smart metering will be an important component. So all the consumers will be metered by smart meters in a progressive manner, and details are available on the websites. A lot of funding will be provided for the distribution companies to go for this smart metering. And once smart metering is deployed and we are able to analyze data, we can take proactive actions and corrective actions as and when required. So this is how we are trying to manage the distribution sectors. And not only the adequacy of capacity is managed by these smart solutions, but we are also trying to bring focus to the quality of power and quality of service delivery for the end consumer by way of these smart energy management solutions. Because these smart meters also have a capability of sending signals for low voltage or any other changes in the voltage conditions at the consumer premises. So with those signals, utility can take corrective action. Beyond smart meters, now we have also, as rooftop solar penetration is increasing, maybe we need reactive power support as well. Globally, smart inverters are getting deployed, wherein the inverters are also capable of providing reactive power support for voltage control for the end utility. And these smart inverters are also equipped with the communication systems which can autonomously take the trigger and act accordingly. The demand forecasting also is one of the ICT solutions or the advanced smart grid solutions that helps utility in managing the power portfolio for procurement. So with these solutions, I think our energy management is becoming smarter. And if we go beyond the grids to the end consumer premises, then participation of the consumer in grid management is also being envisaged in near real future. How an end consumer can participate? They can provide grid support for grid management by way of demand response. So demand response is something wherein a consumer is send a signal to shift their load when the utility is in the need of some such event based on the congestion or say grid stability requirements. So whenever there is some power supply and demand mismatch, the utility may send some price signal to the end consumer based on which the consumer behavior may change, and that in turn brings win-win situation for distribution company as well as in consumer. These price signals can be in the form of time of use tariffs, and the tariffs may be decided dynamically so that it is dependent on the real conditions and not fixed or seasonal only. And for those demand response initiatives, some of the advanced load side equipments are also there now. So the smart ACs and all such devices, smart washing machines, maybe smart refrigerators, which also can be controlled remotely by the utility for the demand response, are now entering into the system. So this is something from my side in terms of how these smart grid solutions can help energy management scenario for the country. Thank you so much.